Let's see. What's the next big thing after large language models? The technology of large language models, which was essentially we could take a piece of text, blank out some amount of it, and then say, what will the next word be? Try and predict it, learn if you get it wrong, and then just repeat over billions of times. You can take picture and blank out bits of it and try to predict what's in the part that's missing. You can take a gene sequence and blank out a piece of it and try and predict it. So this is then a very successful strategy that can be used for all sorts of other domains of human experience and science. So we're going to see a lot of broader use of foundation models in the soon nearby years. Even though large language models have been incredibly successful, they don't really seem to build the kind of world models that human beings have, where they have a sense of stuff in a physical world and particular entities, human beings and their relations, that's more abstracted away from particular sequences of words. And so that suggests we need some kind of different model of artificial intelligence. But I think it's fair to say no one really knows the answer of how to do that successfully. And so that's why we're still doing academic research. AI System asks, what are some of the most promising and exciting real-world applications of NLP that you foresee emerging in the next few years? Tons. So I think we're going to see a lot more NLP systems being deployed very successfully everywhere. So a lot of websites already have a little AI assistant in the bottom corner. I think we're going to see a new generation of ones powered by large language models, which really work much more fluently. I think we're going to see much more use of conversational assistance. So you're thinking about how to word an email to your boss, or you're not quite sure what you should say to your boyfriend. It turns out that you can get advice, drafting help, suggestions of what to say from a large language model that are actually useful these days. You know, I think there's just a whole world of ways that we can use these models because our world is so language-based and that we're all just sort of exploring what some of the possibilities are. In the future, will AI be so smart it won't need human input? I think the honest answer is no one knows. There is a conceivable world at some point in the distant future where an AI system can just learn everything it needs from the world around it, and it doesn't really need us to tell it things. But I think there's also a lot of very heated hype at the moment. Some people think that by 2030, there'll be computers that are better than human beings at almost all tasks. I think a lot of those views are fairly irrational exuberance where people have been getting a little bit too excited by the very genuine big advances we made. But there are other ways in which humans' knowledge and ability to operate in the world is likely to be better than our AI models for a number of decades to come. Will conversational assistants and chatbots replace search engines? I think there are different answers for different kinds of searches. So one case is that people just have a particular question in mind, like when is the primary going to be held in the elections for California? To the extent that I've got a question like that, yeah, absolutely, conversational agents, LLMs, are great for that sort of purpose, that they're faster and better than something else you could use. You can also use them for all kinds of other question answering related purposes. Sometimes people use search when they want to take a deep dive themselves, right? You know, they're buying a new tent and they'd like to make up their own mind. Then there's navigational queries where they just want to be taken to the page, and that's obviously not going to be covered by using a large language model.